penting ini lah, after sah yang berdiskusi dengan yang bayar, mengadu komis untuk ikutan. Ya, kini keron, aku check, oh, follow up, no, mayroon sa mga dikomis untuk agar imong ipresenta sa ato.
Ajay, mayong uto na tong tanan, no, ganina man good, pag ato na ko dito, wala din ako na nangadala ng mga papila kay ang in charge ning ato yung paog, kung sa yung anak, recognition. So, ako gining basahon, ha.
Okay.
Katangiingon nila ni Vice, ganina nga, wala daw na ko tuguti. Ana gipaadto gipatawag, so he's misleading. Akong basahon jud ha, ikan sa akong buhatan adtong April 11, 2023 nagpadala tag sulat ni Vice Mayor Butad. Na diri o, Dear Vice Mayor Butad, in relation to your request for the attendance of the heads of office at your committee meeting, I would like to know the purpose of your inquiry and information that you need regarding the topics outlined in your request, there being under the executive department. I would like to be sure that you can, they can provide you with correct and accurate information to help you in whatever purpose you have in asking for their presence at your committee hearing. If the inquiry is in aid of legislation, I would like to know the legislative measures referred to your committee so I can complete information that you need so we can also prepare the documents that might help you in passing upon the legislative matters. Otherwise, I am concerned that you might be encroaching on some purely executive functions and prerogatives. If that is the case, I can personally attend your committee meeting so you will have the most accurate answers to the questions. So sayop na iyang giingon nga wala na ko tuguti. Akong giingon diri o kato yung giingon nga encroach o akong gibutang diri. Otherwise, I am concerned that you might be encroaching on some purely executive functions and prerogatives. If that is the case, I can personally attend your committee meeting so you will have the most accurate answers to their questions. So in fact, ning offer ko nga pwede ako imo adto. Ning tubag si Vice April 18, 2023. Ano, nagpadala na po kong sulat. Butad. In relation to resolution number 11183-23, which seeks information on the implementation and progress of certain local projects in the municipality of Tambolik Tuwip. The construction of gabions along the Dipolo River is currently on hold, pending the issuance of the government gratuitous permits requested by this august body to the provincial governor Yu. All other materials and transport vehicles needed for the projects are ready and available. So except na lang yun sa mga bato. Attaching ISB resolution number 11-155-23 and 11-165-23, this office sent a letter to the governor on March 3 to apply for a government gratuitous permit. Accordingly, the request was referred to the PINRO on March 13. The acting municipal mayor received the letter from the katong si Vice, katong na-suspend ko, provincial ISB, because at the time the undersigned was preventively suspended. Gi-attach na to ang sulat. On March 15, the Environmental Management Board responded to the letter of the undersigned dated March 8, 2023, applying for a certificate of non-coverage. The EMB required an online application for ECC, which this office complied with on April 12, after the undersigned was reinstated. On the same date, March 15, the Mines and Geosciences Bureau forwarded the request of the undersigned dated March 6 to the provincial governor, emphasizing Section 73-A of the DNR Administrative Order number 2-10-21, which allows the application of a government gratuitous permit for purposes as stated in the request. It is therefore ministerial upon the governor to issue the gratuitous permit. B, the undersigned inquired from the PINRO about the status of his verification and evaluation of the project on April 12. The PINRO has not acted upon the follow-up letter as of this writing. If I may stress to this body that during this time I was preventively suspended So these were all acted upon after I was reinstated. So gani ako na pagbalik nako. The vice mayor may have also taken action during this time, considering the project is immediately and critically necessary. In the offer of the foregoing, I am requesting this body to pass a resolution urging the governor to immediately act on the government gratuitous permit application considering the recommendation of the MGB. I am hereby certifying the urgency of this resolution. Otherwise, if the governor continues ignores our application, I have to ask this council about any legal action that the LGU should resort to given the primordial necessity of this project. Second, concerning the construction of the water intake box of Barangay Riverside, the notice to proceed was issued by the contractor on December 6, 2022, and the project is still ongoing at that time, ongoing pa after my reinstatement. I personally monitor the progress of the project. Engineer Ramir Galambao has taken over the supervision of the project since yesterday, April 17. He was ordered a detailed status report and recommendation to the office of the undersigned. Until then, this office will inform you of the necessary legislative action and measures that should be undertaken. Should the council needs any information, the query can be directed to this office. And according to the local government code, the local chief executive is directly responsible to the Sangguniang Bayan for the program of government, article 87 paragraph B1I. Thank you for your concern. Muna ako gipadala dito. June 27, napadala na po tayo sulat through the presiding board. Read the council practice of bypassing executive power of general supervision and control over all executive officials and employees of the municipality in requiring the appearance of department heads to the exposition. So, ning bypass ng yapon sila, despite sa akong pagpadala ng sulat. Akong gipadala to, dear honorable members, I am writing to bring to the attention of this august body my observation that this council directly requires the appearance of department heads during sessions while blatantly ignoring the power of the executive supervision and control over the executive officials and employees. I would like to request this august body to observe proper protocol in requesting representation from my office in aid of legislation. It is well settled that the mayor has the power to alter, reverse, and modify the acts of his subordinates. Therefore, it is imperative that I should know what acts or information they are giving to the council to ensure that the decision of the council on any legislative measures is aligned with the direction of the LGU. Please see attached copy of the LGU opinion. Ako yung ipadalaan sila the LGU opinion ha? Number 22, series 2009 and the LGU opinion 25, series of 2022 for information and guidance. So, tagaan ako, gid sila. Mabita mo, ingon ko nila nga ato din basahon, diretsyo na lang. Kanin sa DILG legal opinion, ha? It must be stressed, however, that if the persons required by the Sangguniyan is other than the mayor, example, department heads, please reminded of the administrative hierarchy in the city government or the municipal government. This, the municipal government, mayor exercise control and supervision over all officials and employees in his local government units save that of the Sangguniyan. It is just but proper and legal that a department head or any official of the city or the LGU under the mayor's control should first secure the permission or approval of the mayor before any appearance is made. So meaning, dapat mananghig yun. Wa man ta niyo nga dili ta mo padala dito. Ang ako mahibalo ko. Kay nagtanaw di ako nga, bisag unsa na lang dayon niya himuon nga, pataka-taka lang, patay ito, naghimo sila resolution nga, gitubag ko nila sa resolution nga, gi-address ako ah, nga, answering. Unsa ko na resolution nga, gi-answer sa ko ah. Kaning, atong nangaagian ka ng mga suspension. So, manang, careful kay ko, sulat-sulat din ako ah. May yun lang si Vice nga, practice na nila.
Oh,
napagod na oh, napadaan itong May 25. Bahin aning sa Gabions, no? Gianak na ko dire Vice Mayor Butad. I am writing you to follow up the status of my request which was certified as urgent dated April 18. Wa matun lagi to bag, nagpadanap ka. To immediately act on the government gratuitous permit application considering the recommendation of the MGB. Mingon siya nga humana, di na sila mo appeal kay humana. Dili man na kay normal kung unsay kuan dito, ako ibalik dito kay upoy di ka kurang ano gumuad to pa kunila. Local government may be granted agad for the extraction of hit-sized boulders for early recovery of damaged earth dikes following the successive flooding that we experienced. Oh, Mone, ako nang ipadala nila. I would like to also to update this council of the status of application for the gratuitous permit that has not been acted on by the PINRO until now. Atong May 25, ba pa may kwanin ni Ligan? The PINRO replied to my last letter dated April 12. On May 8, in his reply, which came almost a month after, sa kabulan na, hapit na ako sa kabulan labay, the PINRO required documents which are not mandated under DAO 2010-21 at the PBMRB resolution number 0226-2020-0112. Aside from not responding to my request promptly, PINRO Ligan is clearly doing everything to cause a further delay, if not to find cause to disallow our request. Given that this council is very keen on the implementation of this project, I challenge this council to pass the resolution. Meanwhile, I have filed a complaint against PINRO Ligan before the ARTA for not acting within its citizen's charter. The complaint has already been acted by the agency. So, na ko'y ipang-attach ng mga papel. So, mauna siya, Jay. Padulong pa din sa June 26. At noong June 26, nagpadala ko sulat ni Vice. Ang gireceive nila. Dear Vice Mayor Butad, I would like to know the status of the urgent matters submitted to the council for legislation.